In order to subtract decimals, we want to rewrite the problem vertically, lining up the corresponding place values as well as the decimal point. So we'll rewrite this problem as 74.7 minus 18.9. So notice how we have the tens, ones, and tenths lined up properly. So as long as we bring this decimal point down into our difference, we can subtract as we normally would. So we'll start here in the tenths, and we can see right away we have to borrow. We can't take away 9 from 7, so we'll borrow 1 from this 4, so this becomes 3, and then we have a 17 in the tenths column. 17 minus 9 is equal to 8, and then here we have to borrow again, so we'll change the 7 to a 6, this becomes a 13. 13 minus 8 is equal to 5. Then we have 6 minus 1, which is equal to 5. So the difference is 55.8, or 55 and 8 tenths. And we'll do all the other problems in a similar way. We'll first write it vertically, lining up the corresponding place values. So here we'll have 4.58 minus 1.679. Notice how this decimal has 3 digits to the right of the decimal, and this one only has 2. In order to have the decimals have the same number of digits to the right of the decimal, we can add a 0 here in the thousands place value without changing the value of this decimal, which will make the subtraction easier to perform. Starting in the rightmost column, we're going to have to borrow. So we'll borrow 1 from the 8, which makes this 10. 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. Here we have 7 minus 7, that's equal to 0. Here we have to borrow, so we'll change the 4 to a 3, which makes this 15. 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. Bring down the decimal point, and we have 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. Our difference is 2 and 901 thousandths, or 2.901. In this example here, notice we have a whole number minus a decimal. For a whole number, remember the decimal point would be to the right of this 1, which will help us line this up vertically. We'll have 41, the decimal point here, minus 16.7. Again, we'll put a 0 in the tenths place value here, so it's easier to subtract. We'll have to start by borrowing from the 1. This will be 0, this becomes 10. 10 minus 7 is equal to 3. Bring down the decimal point, borrow from the 4. So we have 10 minus 6, that's 4, and 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. So we have 24 and 3 tenths for this difference. Let's go and take a look at our last example. Again, we'll write this vertically. So we have 4.821 minus 1.67. Next, let's go ahead and add a 0 here in the thousands place value so that we can perform the subtraction. We'll bring down the decimal into our difference, and now we'll subtract as we normally do. So we have 1 minus 0, that's 1. Here we have to borrow. This becomes a 7, this becomes 12. 12 minus 7 is equal to 5. 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. And 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So our difference is 3.151, or 3 and 151 thousandths.